all member of the sequence will satisfy this property. Xn plus 1 will be bigger than Xn for all n belongs to the natural number. That means all terms, if you take two conjugative term, then the next term will be bigger than the previous term if it is increasing. Now we'll prove that one. X1 is given 1. So there are a lot of, I already told how to prove Xn plus 1 minus Xn, you can show ratio, you can show, even you can directly apply the same definition. So in order to prove it is increasing or decreasing, we can use Xn plus 1 is greater than Xn. So this X, we can use the original definition. Xn plus 1 is bigger than Xn for all n belongs to the natural number. Or we can show that the difference of this Xn plus 1 minus Xn for increasing, I am writing it is positive for all n. Or we can take the ratio. So tell me out of these three, which one you want to prove the sequence is increasing or decreasing?
First one.
First one.
Okay. So I will use the first one. I can use even second one also. Ratio is not helpful here in this case. So ratio is helpful when some power is there or some factorial will come, then only will use the ratio. So first one I will use here. That means we have to prove that Xn plus 1 is bigger than Xn for all n belongs to the natural number. This we have to show that for all n. So is X2 is bigger than X1 or not? What is the value of X2 in this?
2 by 3.
So
2 by 3.
X2 equal to, so if we put n equal, then we will get X2 value is 1 by 3 X1 plus 1. That is 1 by 3, X1 value is 1, 1 plus 1, it is 2 by 3. So is X1 is bigger than X2 or not?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
X1 equal to 1 and X2 equal to 2 by 3. So which one is bigger? X1 is bigger or X2 is bigger?
X1.
So it is clear that X1 is bigger than X2. This is number one I'm writing here. In order to show that Xn plus 1 is bigger than Xn, we have to show it is for all n. Like X2 will be bigger than X3, then X3 will be bigger than X4, and so on. So do you know any technique how to do this? So that it will prove for all n, or we will do for all n one by one.
So
we have to use
induction.
Mathematical induction.
Yes,
mathematical
we have induction. To use mathematical induction. Yeah, so for case 1, n equal to 1, it is true. X1 is bigger than X2. Now we'll assume the step number 2 that...
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, this one is a decreasing sequence.
It is decreasing sequence.
Okay.
X1 is bigger than X2, so we don't know it is increasing or decreasing. We are proving.
So we have to prove Xn plus 1 is greater than equal to Xn.
Yeah, if the n plus 1 term is less than Xn, then it is decreasing. If it is greater, it is increasing.
Okay, sir.
So X1 is bigger than X2, so for applying the induction, I am assuming that xk is bigger than or equal to xk plus 1. So up to k, it is true. This is for k equal to 1, 2, sorry, n equal to 1 to k. So 1 to k. So now what we have to show that? This one, the step second, I assume. This is the induction step, so I assume that. So this one is assumed that xk plus 1 will be bigger than, sorry, xk plus 1 will be bigger than, so that I assume. So now what will be the next step?
Xk plus 1 greater than or equal to xk plus
2. Yeah, xk plus 1 should be bigger than xk plus 2. So that we have to show. Xk plus, that we have to show will be bigger than xk plus 2 or not. So how to prove this? I will find xk plus 2 and I will prove it is less than xk plus 1. So what is the value of xk plus 2 from this? The original sequence it is given xn plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 xn plus 1. So what is the value of xk plus 2? 1 by 3 xk plus 1 by xk plus 2 1 by 3 xk plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So this is the value of xk plus 2 and we have to show that this is, or xk plus 2 is less than xk plus 1. So now can we use the number 1 and 2 and say something?
So we have to put the value xk plus 1. Then we have to find the xk plus 2. Then we compare that xk plus 1 is greater than xk plus 2. Can we conclude?
Yeah, so tell me what you want to say. See, this xk plus 1 we have to show that if you calculate xk plus 1, it will come 1 by 3 this plus 1. So,
this, so
from this,
so we have assumed
we will subtract both, we will subtract both the equations and then xk plus 1 minus xk on the right side will be greater than 0 because we have already assumed that.
Yes. So now
therefore,
we,
yes. LHS will so be we, also greater than.
So if you subtract this, then you will get xk plus 1 minus xk plus, sorry, xk plus 2 minus xk plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 xk plus 1 minus xk. And we assume that xk is bigger than xk plus 1. So right hand side will be negative. So we are done by induction. So hence by mathematical induction, it is true for all n. That means the given sequence is decreasing. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Or,
yes.
Or anyone have doubt?
Sir.
Yes. So here what I did, x1 equal to 1, I found x2 and I checked which one is bigger. So clearly x1 is bigger than x2, so that sequence may be the decreasing sequence. It can never be increasing, because if it is increasing then x2 must be bigger than x1, so there is no chance of increasing. So I did x1 greater than x2, we can clearly say. Then by induction we assume the induction step xk plus xk is bigger than xk plus 1, and I proved that xk plus 1 is bigger than xk plus 2. So by mathematical induction it is true for all n that the sequence is decreasing. Okay, so now when we will say this sequence is convergent according to the this result, if the sequence is decreasing and it is bounded below, then only we will say the sequence is convergent and it will converge to the infimum. So now we will show that this sequence is bounded below. So can you tell me the bound of this sequence? Sequence is decreasing, we proved. Now my question is that can we show that it is a bounded below? That means all terms should be bigger than that. Some one bound we need, one lower bound.
Zero.
0
1 by 2
1 by 2 okay, can we say
1 by 2 number? 3
yeah 1 by 2 okay. 1 by 2 that means we have to show that all terms, if it is the bound, lower bound, that means all the term of the sequence will be bigger than 1 by 2 right? So we'll prove that it is bounded below. So here I want to show that xn will be bigger than or equal to half, and that is true for all n. That means all terms of the sequence is bigger than this. That means the number half is the lower bound of this sequence. That means the sequence is bounded below. So again we'll use the induction here. What is the value of x1? X1 equal to 1, which is clearly bigger than half. What is the value of x2? So x2 is bigger than half because x1 is bigger than half. So x2 will also be the bigger than. This is 1 by 3. If you put half plus 1, you will get half. So x1 is bigger than half. X2 is also bigger than half. You have to show that all terms are bigger than half. Again, we'll use the induction. Suppose xk is bigger than half. This I assume. Assume for k equal to 1 to n, like up to n, and then we'll so for xn plus 1 will also be the bigger than half, or if you assume for k, then k plus 1 will also be the bigger than half. That is also
sir, x1
yes?
equal to 1 by 2 y, sir.
X1 equal to 1, not 1 by 2,
but you have given 1 by 2 there. X2 equal to 1 by 3 x1 plus 1.
Yeah, x2 equal to 1 by 3 x1 plus 1 by the formula.
Yes, sir.
If you calculate x2, it will come 1 by 3 x1 plus 1. And x1 is bigger than half. Even if you not write this, that doesn't. X1 is bigger than half, xk you assume and prove xk plus 1 will be bigger than half or not.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, how did we conclude that half will be the infimum? Like, how did you start with half?
Yeah, that I will tell. Wait. So here, by induction, we have to write by mathematical induction.
Sir,
the sequence is bigger than half. That means it is lower bound. It is decreasing sequence, so it must converge.
Excuse me,
yes.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, I couldn't understand that x2 is equal to 1 by 3 into x1 plus 1. And after that, what you have written?
See, x1 is bigger than half. So if you put a half value, then definitely left hand side will be bigger than right hand side. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So I put half the minimum value. So that side is lower, that side is bigger.
Okay.
Similarly, the same idea I used here, this xk plus 1 is bigger than half. So if you put half, then xk plus 1 will be bigger than half. So it has a lower bound and the sequence is decreasing. So definite sequence of half. So this proof is clear, then I will explain why this half came in the picture. So if exam question will come, so you have to do like this only. You have to use the induction to show.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I didn't get that last line, sir. Xk plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 xk.
Yeah, 1 by 3 xk plus 1, that is the by definition only that function that given like this.
Huh.
If you xk no, sir, plus 1
after that, that greater than equal to
by induction. See, by induction you assume that xk is bigger than half. So if you put minimum value, then definitely this is bigger than this. Yes or no? This xk is bigger than half, and I am putting the minimum value. So definitely this side is bigger than this. Left hand side is bigger than right hand side. So you will get half. That means xk plus 1 is also bigger than half. So by induction,
yes, sir, got it.
For all natural number, it is bigger than half. So now I will tell you how this half came in the picture. The sequence is decreasing, yes or no?
That yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Here I
proved yes, sir. It
is decreasing. Yeah.
Yes,
here
sir.
I proved it is decreasing. And here I proved that it is bounded below. So now I will show why this half came in the picture suddenly. So if sequence is decreasing, then what is the relation between xn and xn plus 1? If sequence is decreasing, then which one is bigger?
Xn plus 1 is less than xn. Xn plus 1 is less than xn.
Okay, what is the difference of this xn plus 1 and minus xn if the sequence is decreasing?
Less than 0.
Less than 0.
Okay. Equal to
0.
Less than
so 0. For this problem, I already proved that this sequence is decreasing. Okay. That is already done. So you Google doesn't have any doubt in that. So xn plus 1 is given in this question 1 by 3. Xn plus 1, this is the given minus xn. So can you tell me what is the difference after solving this? 1 by 3 is anyway common. Just do a little bit calculation and tell me.
Minus 2 by 3 plus
minus 2 by 3 xn.
Yeah, 1 by 3 is common and then tell me what will come.
1 minus 2 xn.
1 minus
2 xn.
1 minus 2 xn. Suppose it is decreasing. Decreasing means it is less than 0. Then what will be the value of xn if it is decreasing?
greater than equal to 1 by 2.
So that 1 by 2 came here from here. So if you put xn is greater than half, by this it is showing that it is decreasing. If you prove it is decreasing, then it will prove that xn is less than half. So here you have to prove only one times if you do like this, and there is no confusion why half. Very much clear that it is less than 0, so x1 must be greater than or equal to half. So I hope it is clear from this.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
No. Sir, we proved that 1 by 2 is the lower bound. But yes. How can we tell that 1 by 2 is the infimum?
Yeah, I am not saying it is infimum. I am saying it is lower bound, so it will converge. So the result says that it is decreasing and bounded below, then it will converge. It will converge to infimum. Till now I didn't prove. Even I didn't found infimum. I am just saying it is lower bound. I am not saying it is the greatest lower bound. It is the lower bound, that's all.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, actually xn minus 1 and xn tends to infinity, it is 1 by 2. From that can you say that xn?
Yeah, from that only I will calculate. So now I will find the limit of this sequence. So just so here in we have to find the limit of the sequence. So I will use that epsilon definition to find this limit. So if xn converging to L, that means the limit of xn is L, then xn plus 1 will also goes to L. Anyone have doubt and why xn plus 1 will also converge to the same limit L? Because why I am saying xn converging to L, because I already proved that this sequence is convergent. If it is convergent, it has a unique limit. So that limit I am assuming it is L. And if I will able to find L, then the limit of xn is L. So since sequence is convergent, by proving it is decreasing and bounded below. So definitely it will converge to some limit, and that limit I assume L. So xn goes to L as n tends to infinity. That means if you apply n tends to infinity, the left hand side will give L, right hand side will give 1 by 3 L plus 1, and from here you can calculate what is the value of L. So just calculate and tell me what is the value of L, then L will be the limit.
1 by 2.
Yeah, 1 by 2. So the limit of this sequence is 1 by 2. So the, so like that we'll not find supremum or infimum in this case, because we can use directly have the formula and we have the relation in the limit, so we can use that one. So here what I use, that if xn goes to L, then xn plus 1 have also the same limit. Why? Because if suppose the sequence will start from 1, 2, 3, like x1, x2, x3, and xn plus 1 means it will start from x2, not from 1. It will, if n equal to n belongs to natural number, that means it will start from 2, but remaining terms are same. But the definition of the sequence says that there exists a natural number, after that all the terms lie in that epsilon bound. So for that is true for xn also, and that is true for xn plus 1 also. I already shown the picture. So after that there exists n, that n will work for both the sequence, even for xn, even for xn plus 1. Because if suppose after 20 all the terms lie in this, then after 21 also all the terms will lie. So that's why both the sequence have the same limit by the epsilon definition. So the limit came half. Yeah, any doubt if you have, then tell me. If no doubt, then I can move.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, here why we have put xn plus 1 is equal to L and xn is also equal to L. What is the need?
See, I have to find the limit. Right?
Okay.
I have to find the limit. Since if this sequence is decreasing, it is proved, it has a bound, so definitely it will converge. And if it will converge, then it has a limit. And that limit is unique. That means that is guarantee that the limit of this sequence will exist and it is something L. Okay. So now if you apply limit in this, then right hand side and left hand side you can put, after applying the limit, you will get L and L. Then you can calculate L also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, now can we say that half is infimum or not?
Yes, yes, definitely. But you can say half is infimum.
Because it is limit or...
Yes, you can say definitely half is the infimum.
Thank you, sir.
So now the next one is the Cauchy sequence. See, the original definition of the sequence have xn minus something. I will show you the original definition. There is one drawback with the original definition if you apply for this. Like xn minus L is less than epsilon. Suppose some question is given so that limit is this, then this definition is useful. Like suppose something is given like sin n by n, that sequence will converge to 0, or 1 by n will converge to 0. If the question is like this, then you know where it will converge, you have to prove, then you can use the definition, because you know xn, you know L. Suppose you don't have the limit L, then how you will use this definition? You cannot use this definition. Then you have to use, there is one criteria we already seen, you have to prove that it is either increasing or decreasing. And then upper bound or lower bound, based on that you can conclude that the sequence is convergent or divergent. That means whatever definition we have seen, the limit definition, in that definition it is required that we have the limit. That's why area that increasing sequence which is bounded, in that procedure no need of any limit. Without limit we can prove that the sequence is convergent, and even we can find, and we already shown. So now the next one is the Cauchy sequence. The definition is almost same. The thing is that here we are taking the difference between two terms of the sequence. The original limit is not here, so without knowing the limit also we can prove that the sequence is convergent or divergent. So difficulty to find the limit, then you can use this Cauchy criteria or this monotone criteria, that means this increasing or decreasing. Here no, you have the original limit. So what this definition says, that the sequence is called Cauchy if for every epsilon positive, that means no need to worry about epsilon. What you have to do, you have to find the natural number like you are finding in the original definition. You have to find the natural number such that the difference between these two term xm minus xn will be less than epsilon for all n bigger than this n0. That means that there exists that natural number, means you have to find n0 such that after that, whenever you will choose any two terms of the sequence, if you find a difference, that difference must be epsilon, less than epsilon. Then we will say that the sequence is convergent, sequence is Cauchy sequence. And there is an alternate result. If sequence is convergent, it is Cauchy. Here it is written I double F, means if and only if, that means both sides is true. If sequence is Cauchy, it is convergent. And if it is convergent, then it is Cauchy. That means every convergent sequence is Cauchy and every Cauchy sequence is convergent. So if you prove it is Cauchy sequence, definitely it will converge. If it is convergent, that means that is a Cauchy sequence. So both sides it is true. So like we'll see this example. Suppose this is the example. You have to show that this sequence is convergent. Can anyone tell what is the limit of this sequence?
E to the power n.
Limit cannot be come in terms of n. It is infinity goes to where? N tends to infinity. What will be that? Yes?
Infinity.
1.
So answer will be E.
Zero.
Sir,
1.
Sir,
1. Sir, E raised to
1. 0,
one.
Sir. E.
Yeah.
E.
Huh?
Zero. Sir, 0.
0.
2, sir.
0.
1.
How E raised to 1. Zero?
Okay, we'll prove that this is a Cauchy sequence. If it is Cauchy sequence, it will converge.
One, sir. One.
One, sir. Okay, we'll see later. First, we'll prove it is convergent or not.
E.
If it is divergent, then there does not exist any limit.
E, sir.
Yeah. First, we'll see it is convergent. I mean, it is Cauchy sequence or not. If it is Cauchy sequence, it is easy to prove that it is convergent, because every Cauchy sequence is convergent. So here I will prove that this sequence is Cauchy sequence. So for Cauchy sequence, what we'll do, for every epsilon positive, so that is the given epsilon, and we have to find the natural number. So that is given, epsilon is positive, and now we'll find xm minus xn. So just to see the definition, we have to find this difference xm minus xn is less than epsilon for what natural number? That natural number we have to find. Okay, so we'll find that natural number such that this xm minus xn is less than epsilon. So whenever any sequence in the form of this series, then that ratio or that, sorry, this difference is very useful. When it is in the form of factorial, then ratio is very useful. So now we'll choose m and n, xm minus xn, I want to find this mod. So which one you want to bigger, xm or xn, you just tell me, I will take that one. Because out of m and n, both are natural numbers, so either m is bigger or n. So suppose n equal to 7, then m can be 47 also. So which one you want bigger, that tell me, I will choose that one only.
M bigger.
So I'm assuming m is bigger than n. Even n is bigger than m, doesn't matter. So according to the definition, xm will be, it will start from 1, it will go up to 1 by factorial m, and then you have to subtract by xn, that means 1 to 1 upon factorial m. So can anyone tell what will be the difference?
1 by m factorial minus 1 by
1 by n factorial to 1 by m.
Yeah, tell me what will come. I will write the terms.
1 by n factorial to 1 by m factorial.
1 by n factorial to?
1 by m factorial.
1 by m factorial.
Sir, it will start from 1 by n plus 1 factorial.
Yes, it will start from 1 by n plus 1. It will not start from n because up to n it will cancel out with the xm. Xm also have the up to factorial n. So it will start from n plus 1. So the first term will come n plus 1. N plus 1 factorial. Then n plus 2 factorial. And it will go up to m factorial. Is it okay for everyone?
Yes, sir.
How did you do?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
N plus 2. It's factorial and m factorial. See, someone is asking how I am doing. You just write xm. Xm will come 1, 1 by factorial 1, 1 by 2 factorial 2, 1 by factorial n. Then next term will come 1 by factorial n plus 1. It will go up to 1 by factorial m. Because it is xm and m is bigger than n. So it will go up to 1 by factorial m. Then if you subtract this all term, you will get the remaining term from n plus 1 to factorial m. Like if you are doing x7 minus x3, then it will start from up to 7 and remove the up to 3 factorial. That means what are the remaining term? It will start from 4, it will go up to 7. So now if we want to do this is less than epsilon, it is very difficult to find. So what we'll do, we'll do a little bit calculation. So do you know any series? Any series, some name of any series where you can find the sum of that series or some formula of that one.
Sir,
yes,
2 to the power n divided by n factorial.
Taylor series.
Yes, that, yeah, Taylor series. Any other series?
Arithmetic.
Yeah, arithmetic progression. You know, exponential. Yes, you know, geometric maybe.
Fibonacci series.
Yeah, that also, you know, Fibonacci. Geometric. So we'll see. Yeah, someone is saying n plus 1, some 2 to the power something, someone is saying even
sir,
the last 2 class.
To the power n.
Yes. So we'll approximate this
sir,
factorial.
2 to the power n divided by factorials.
Yeah, so n plus 1 factorial I'm writing. Similarly, you can write even other factorial also. This value is 1 into 2 into 3 up to n plus 1. And it is 1 by, so I am writing it is 1 by. So can I write this is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How many times? So this 1 by 1, I am not changing. 1 by 2 is also 1 by 2. This is the first 1 by 2. Then 1 by 3, then 1 by 2 is bigger than 1 by 3. Even from 1 by 4 also 1 by 2 is bigger. Even 1 by n plus 1 also 1 by 2 is bigger. Because this one I am not changing. 1 by 1, the first term. Then 1 by 2, 1 by 3, total n plus 1 terms. But I am replacing from 2 onward. So it is 2 to the power n. So this term 1 by factorial n plus 1 is less than equal to 1 by 2 to the power n. Similarly, this n plus 1 will become less than 1 upon 2 to the power. So I am using this result here. So xm plus minus xn this mod will be less than
sir,
1 upon, yes?
Sir, why have you taken that 1 by 1, then 1 by 2, 1 by 2? Can't we take see, first term as 1 by 2?
No, here it is 1 by 1. The factorial n plus 1 will start from 1, you 1, then 2, 3. Even if you will not write, doesn't matter. Factorial n plus 1 means 1 into 2 into 3. So first term will be 1 by 1. second term will be 1 by 2, then third term will be 1 by 3. All I am replacing by 1 by 2, but 1 by 1 I am not replacing because it is not greater than that, because 1 is bigger than half. Yes or no?
Okay.
So see, all terms are positive, so there is no need of mod. So the first term will come. See, all terms are positive only, so even if you put mod, even between sign is plus, so I am removing mod. So the first term will come 2 to the power n here, plus second term will become 1 upon 2 to the power n plus 1.
So
what will be the last term? 1 by factorial m.
1 by 2 to the power
m minus 1 because it is less 1. So now this is the infinite GP geometric series. What will be the sum of this? Can you do the sum? How many terms in this series and what will be the sum formula? This is the GP series with the common ratio half.
So why we replaced by 1 by 2 only?
Yeah, you can half replace only. You can replace by some other number also, because I want to form a GP series. That's why I replace by 1 by 2. You can replace by 1 by 4 also.
Okay.
Even you can replace by 1 by 3 also. Yeah, it's not compulsory.
Okay. Okay.
So now this is the GP series. Sir, so what? How many terms in this series and what will be the sum? Yes.
Sir, if we would have taken. Sir.
Yes.
Sir, if we would have taken 1 by 1.
Yes, 1 by 1.
Sir, instead of 1 by 1, if you take 1 by 2, then that.
No, I cannot take 1 by 2 because then this inequality I cannot write.
So why?
See one and one by two. Which one is bigger?
One.
So how I can write? That's why I'm not changing. Which one is bigger? Those only I'm writing.
Oh.
See, okay. 1 by 2 here, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 2 is definitely bigger than 1 by 2.
Mm-hmm.
So like that.
Okay.
So now tell me how many terms in this, and what is the sum?
M n.
So yeah, total m minus n. Yeah, so then what is the sum formula? That the first term is 1 by 2 to the power n. Then something 1 minus r is half. R to the half. Power how many? And ratio 1 by half. So here total m minus n terms. So this one. This is the GP series formula. The sum of GP series. And this half, the bottom, it will give half only, so it will become 2 by 2 to the power n, 1 minus half m minus n. Up to this, anyone have doubt? Now I can directly approximate it is less than epsilon and I can find the natural number. If this is done, then this quantity is less than 1, because 1 minus some positive quantity is less than 1. So definitely this quantity will be greater than this, which is equal to 1 upon 2 to the power n minus 1. If it is less than epsilon, then you can find the natural number. So find the natural number which will satisfy this criteria. That natural number will work. And this sequence is Cauchy sequence.
Sir, last step again, can you explain please?
Yeah, here 1 minus something is written. Is this GP sum, anyone have any doubt? GP series formula.
Yes,
no. That's 1 minus. Yeah, no doubt, right? So this 1 minus half is half. So this 2 will go up. It will become 2 by 2 to the power n. And here it is same as 1 minus half to the power m minus n. And this quantity in the bracket is less than 1, because 1 minus something is less than 1. So this is less than 1 means this 1, 2 by 2 to the power n will be bigger than this. So I am putting the maximum value here 1. So that's why this is less than this. So it will become 2, 1 upon 2 to the power n minus 1 if it is less than epsilon. So you can find the n in terms of epsilon. And then you have to take the integer part and that n will work. That means from that n onward, all term will, that difference between this term will be less than epsilon. So this sequence is Cauchy sequence. Here the only thing is left, you have to find the L. So take the log and tell me what is the value of N. N must be greater than what? You can take log base 2 also. So what is the value of N?
1 minus log epsilon base 2.
1 minus log
N greater epsilon log base 2.
Base 2.
Yes.
This much?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And then you have to you have to take the integer of this. Then you will get the natural number N0. So whenever N bigger than this number, that difference will be less than epsilon. So this sequence is Cauchy sequence. So from this example, you can clearly see that applying the definition of Cauchy sequence to solve the problem is very difficult. Very difficult means always you will get something like this only. So that's why some alternate criteria people develop. You can directly use those criteria, and the proof of that criteria is exactly same as whatever I did in this example. So I will show those criteria. So this is the criteria. So instead of applying the actual definition of epsilon, any sequence will satisfy this property A, then you will say that this sequence will convergent when alpha lies between 0 and 1. Even if you satisfy this property also, then also the sequence is Cauchy. So for Cauchy sequence, these two criteria are easy to check the sequence is Cauchy as compared to the original definition. So in exam, if it will come, then try to do by this. And the proof of these two also the same as whatever I did in the original one. That is already given in the book. So I am not doing here. So either we can use this criteria or we can use this criteria. So now the question is this one. We have to show that the sequence is convergent and also find its limit also. So first check whether this sequence is increasing or decreasing. By increasing decreasing method. Then I will show by Cauchy method also.
Decreasing.
So this is decreasing. If it is bounded
decreasing.
Above, then it will converge. Okay, so by that method you can do yourself. Now I am doing by this Cauchy sequence. So out of this, I want to do this difference. I will see which one is work. Alpha to the power n, if it will come, and alpha lies between 0 to 1, then we will say it is a Cauchy sequence. Otherwise, the second one. So I will take the difference of xn plus 1 minus xn. Or you can take the difference of xn plus 2 minus xn plus 1. So I don't know which one will work. So I am just applying the one only, any one. So I am just taking the difference of xn plus 1 minus xn, this mod. So xn plus 1 is this one minus. So minus xn is 2 plus xn minus 1. So now we have to just simplify this. Take the LCM. What you will get in the numerator, just tell me. In the denominator, you will get this one. This xn and 2 plus xn minus 1. So on the top you will get xn minus 1 minus xn. So after this, can you suggest me which one is implemented out of this A and B? Here the difference of this is alpha times the difference of the
B.
So suppose I want to implement B. So this is xn plus 1 minus xn, this difference, here it is written xn minus 1 minus xn, or you can write the xn minus 1. And then alpha something, we have to approximate this. That means something will come here, mod xn minus xn minus 1. If this will hold, then we'll say that this sequence is Cauchy, and this is alpha we have
convergent
to
find.
Yeah, so what will be the value of alpha? So here this xn plus 2 minus xn plus 1, and here it is written xn plus 1 minus xn. So alpha, if it is less than 1, then only it is convergent, it is Cauchy sequence. So how to find this alpha? And this is less or equal to, not equal to alpha, it can be less also. So we have to put something less than this. So 2 plus xn is less than which number? Can I write it is less than 1 by 2? Similarly, 2 plus xn minus 1 is also less than 1 by 2. Then overall it is 1 by 4. So it is a Cauchy sequence. It is less than 1 by 4. So alpha is less than 1. So this sequence is Cauchy.
Yes.
Because this sequence, this one, while because you see 2 plus xn and 2, which one is bigger? 2 plus xn is bigger or 2 is bigger? Suppose 2 plus something 2 plus you are adding. Yeah, 2 plus xn. So if it is 1 by 2 plus xn or 1 by 2, which one is bigger? 1 by 2 is bigger.
1 by 2.
Similarly, one here also 1 by 2 bigger, so I replace by 1 by 2 here, so it is 1 by 4, it is less than alpha, means less than 1, so this is Cauchy. And why I am saying it is 2 plus xn, this is 1 by 2, because this is a positive sequence only, all are positive terms, there is no negative. So definitely it will be less or equal to half, so this sequence is a Cauchy sequence. This is the end of the sequence. The only thing is left, so in the next class, come with your doubt, whatever doubt you have so far I discuss, or some other doubt, we'll discuss.